وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. What we're going to be talking about today, insha'Allah ta'ala, in this Ramadan daily droplets, is Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr, the opportunity of a lifetime. It's an opportunity that you can't put a price on it. An opportunity that the one who takes advantage of it is truly sa'id, truly happy. And the one who is prevented from the good of it is truly shaqi, is truly wretched. The one who knows what Laylatul Qadr is really worth races and rushes to do more and more, to do more than they would have otherwise done. And the one who doesn't really realize its value, perhaps that person might find themselves sleeping or might find themselves lazy and then may cause themselves to feel a very strong regret over what they've done. Inna fi dhalika la dhikra liman kana lahu qalbun aw alqa as-sam'a wa huwa shahid. In this there is a reminder for the one who has a heart, or the one who lends an ear, the one who witnesses the words that remind them. Laylatul Qadr has a surah which was revealed only about it, uniquely about it. And this surah has a number of virtues of Laylatul Qadr within it. Allah Azza wa Jal said, Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr, wama adaraka ma Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadri khayrun min alfi shahr. Tanazzalul malaikatu wal ruhu fiha bi'idhni rabbihim min kulli amr. Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr. From the virtues that this surah tells us about, first of all, is that Allah Azza wa Jalla sent down an entire surah for the explaining and dealing with the topic of Laylatul Qadr. That's one of the things that tells us the virtue of this night. That Allah Azza wa Jalla sent down the Qur'an that is a guidance for mankind, that is the cause for their happiness, that brings them out from the darkness into the light. Allah Azza wa Jalla revealed this Qur'an on Laylatul Qadr. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatul Qadr. We sent it down on Laylatul Qadr. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ. And what will make you know what Laylatul Qadr is? This sentence itself shows you the ta'zeem, the greatness and the importance of Laylatul Qadr in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Laylatul Qadr is better than 1,000 months. 1,000 months calculates to 83 years and 4 months. Subhanallah, it's a lifetime of worship. That's a lifetime of worship in one night. Perhaps that night may only be a few short hours in length. Someone may only have the night, it may only be a handful of hours. And those handful of hours, perhaps each hour is worth a decade. Perhaps each hour is worth a decade of ibadah. It's worth an entire 10 years of ibadah. Because as we said, the entire night, it equates to 1,000 months, 83 years plus of worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal in one night. تَنَزَّلُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْرُوحُ فِيهَا. The angels and ar-ruh, Jibreel alayhi salam, they descend in it. And the angels, they only descend with al-khayr, wal-barakah, wal-rahmah, with goodness and blessings and mercy. Salamun hiya hatta matla'il fajr. It's a night of salam. And it's a night of as-salama min al-azab wal-iqab. It's a night of being saved from punishment. And a night of obedience to Allah Azza wa Jal. It's a night about which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Man qama laylatal qadri imanan wa ihtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi. Whoever stands on Laylatul Qadr with iman and hoping in the reward of Allah, ihtisab, expecting and hoping for Allah's reward, all of their previous sins will be forgiven. This is opportunity of a lifetime. So where should we look for this opportunity? Where is it? When is it going to come? Which night is it going to be? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, "Iltamisuha fil ashr al awakhir fi kulli witr." The hadith narrated by al-Bukhari, he said, seek it out during the last 10 nights of Ramadan, in every odd night. So this here tells us the first mistake that so many people make as it relates to Laylatul Qadr. And that is that they select one night alone and they make all of their effort on that one night. For example, the 27th night. And they come out and they bring out their family and they do everything that they can on that one night. But that's not what the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ tells us. Rather, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Iltamisuha," look for it, search for it, seek it in the last 10 nights, fi kulli witr, in every odd numbered night. But that in itself could lead to another mistake. And that is the people who only make the effort on the odd nights and not on the even nights. But someone might ask the question, how could that be? Because didn't the Prophet ﷺ say fi kulli witr in every odd night? He did. But in the hadith of Ibn Abbas, radiallahu anhuma, the Prophet ﷺ, and the hadith also in Bukhari, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Iltamisuha fil ashr al awakhir min Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr. في تاسعة تبقى في سابعة تبقى في خامسة تبقى." He said, look for it in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Look for Laylatul Qadr in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. When 9 nights remain, or 7 nights remain, or 5 nights remain. And that shows us that some of the ahadith, they count Laylatul Qadr, the odd nights, from the beginning of the month. And the other ahadith, they count the odd nights from the end of the month. And as you know, the month could be 29 days, it could be 30 days. And so it may be that the nights you think are odd actually turn out to be even. And it may be that the nights that you think were even turn out to be odd. Perhaps everyone gathers together on a night, they think it's the 27th night, but it might not be considered to be the night of Laylatul Qadr, according to the way the different ahadith. So what's the solution? The solution is to stand all of those nights in prayer, not to miss one night. For whoever stands those 10 nights, all of them, iman and wahtisaba, that person has stood on Laylatul Qadr. And from this is a beautiful hadith, the hadith of Zir ibn Hubaysh, that he said, سَأَلْتُ أُبَيَّ بْنَ كَعْبْ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ فَقُلْتُ إن أخاك ابن مسعود يقول من يقم الحول يصب ليلة القدر فقال رحمه الله أراد أن لا يتكل أراد أن لا يتكل الناس. Zir ibn Hubaysh, he narrates, he said that I asked Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu an, that your brother Ibn Mas'ud, he says whoever stands the whole year in prayer will definitely have stood Laylatul Qadr. They will have caught Laylatul Qadr. Subhanallah. Look at the understanding of Ibn Mas'ud. He said, if you want to get Laylatul Qadr, stand every night of the year in prayer. Subhanallah. And Ubay ibn Ka'b explained what Ibn Mas'ud meant. He said, أَرَادَ أَن لَا يَتَّكِلَ النَّاسِ. He wanted to make sure that people don't become lazy and reliant on one night. Even though Ubay ibn Ka'b goes on to talk about the virtue or the specific night of the 27th night. But subhanAllah, the understanding of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum and their actions, they indicate seeking it in all of those nights. To the point that Ibn Mas'ud used to seek it in the whole year. I.e., not necessarily that Laylatul Qadr happens in the whole year, but that he sought it by making sure that he didn't miss a single night of the year. يَقُمِ الْحَوْلِ يُصِبْ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. Whoever stands all year has caught Laylatul Qadr. So this is the mentality that we want people to have, all of the 10 nights. Not to be, let me calculate which is odd, which is even. Let me calculate which it could be, which is the 27th night. Let me put all of my energy on that. Because subhanAllah, you don't know, it may be that the night comes on a night that you were not expecting it to be. As for the way that the Prophet ﷺ used to be on that night, and Allah Azza wa Jalla said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You have in the Messenger of Allah the best example. It's narrated, كَانَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ يَجْتَهِدُ فِي الْعَشْرِ الْأَوَاخِرِ مَا لَيَجْتَهِدُ فِي غَيْرِهَا. The Messenger of Allah ﷺ used to work hard in the last 10 days, to an extent that he worked harder than he did in any of the other 10 days. And he made more efforts to worship Allah than any of the rest of the days of the year. And that's, look at the guidance of the Prophet ﷺ. He didn't make that effort on one night. In all of the 10 nights, he made an effort that he wouldn't make any other time from any of the other nights. And in another narration, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا دخل العشر شد مئزره وأحيا ليله وأيقظ أهله. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the 10 days would come in Ramadan, the last 10 nights of Ramadan, he would شد مئزره, he would tighten his belt, he would become serious, and he would, what we sometimes say in English, knuckle down, you know, really concentrate and put that effort in. وَأَحْيَا لَيْلَ, and he made his whole night come alive. So the Prophet ﷺ, he behaved differently in the last 10 nights. The whole night he spent it awake. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَحْيَا لَيْلَ, he made his whole night come alive. وَأَيْقَظَ أَهْلَ, and he would wake up his family. He would wake up his family. And you have an excellent example in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And our mother Aisha, she said, قُلْتُ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَرَأَيْتَ إِنْ عَلِمْتُ أَيَّ لَيْلَةٍ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ مَا أَقُولُ فِيهَا. She said, O Messenger of Allah, if I know which night Laylatul Qadr is, what should I say in it? قَالَ قُولِي, he said, say, اللَّهُمَّ إِنَّكَ عَفُوٌ تُحِبُّ الْعَفْوَ فَعْفُ عَنِّي. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, you are afu, you love to pardon, so pardon me. Oh Allah, you are afu, you pardon frequently. You frequently overlook and pardon and forgive. And you love to pardon your servants, so pardon me. And this is a dua that all throughout the last 10 nights of Ramadan, we should have this habit of making regularly. Allahumma innaka afuun تُحِبُّ الْعَفْوَ فَعْفُ عَنِّي. And Imam Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, أُحِبُّ إِذَا دَخَلَ الْعَشَرَ الْأَوَاخِرِ أَنْ يَتَهَجَّدْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَيَجْتَهِدَ فِيهِ. He said that my preference, what I love, is that when the last 10 days come, that the person should pray the tahajjud at night time, and they should make real strong efforts in it. No, subhanAllah, lengthen the qiyam, lengthen the ruku', lengthen the sujood, make a lot of dua in it. And the person should get their family and their wife and their children, they should wake them up to pray if they're able to do so. I mean, if their wife and their children, their family and their children, they're able to wake up, they should wake them up to pray. And Imam Sufyan al-Thawri, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, الدُعَاءُ فِي تِلْكَ اللَّيْلَ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِنَ الصَّلَةِ. He said, dua on that night is more beloved to me than the prayer. And subhanAllah, look at the opportunities you have to combine. In your prayer, you have the time of sujood, when the Prophet ﷺ, he told us to make a lot of dua in it. فَأَكْثِرُوا فِيهِ مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ, make a lot of dua in it. And you have the tashahud. After the time when you finished making the tashahud, the Prophet ﷺ said, فَلْيَتَخَيَّرْ مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ أعجبه إليه. Let him choose from the dua the one that he is the most pleasing, that's the most pleasing to him. You have the qunut in the witr, the dua that you make in the witr. SubhanAllah, so many opportunities for dua, combining the salah, combining the dua, making the tahajjud at night, praying in the last third of the night if you're able, working really hard, lengthening the qiyam and the ruku' and the sujood, making a lot of dua after you finish the tashahud, and making dua as a part of the witr as well. SubhanAllah, these are the opportunities. But you should also not forget the opportunity of the daytime as well. And that's why Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentioned the recommendation and he said that his preference was أن يكون اجتهاده في نهاره كاجتهاده في ليلها. He said that the person's efforts that they make in the daytime should be like the efforts that they make in the nighttime. And it's narrated that some of the Salaf, they would make ghusl for every night from the nights of the last 10 days. And some of them, they would wear perfume for it. Some of them, they would put on perfume to stand in those nights. So subhanAllah, this is our opportunity now. The opportunity of a lifetime. Lifetime of worship in one single night, but you don't know which night it is. So every single night you have to make an effort right from now. This video is released from the very first of the 10 nights all the way through to the very end. And you make as much effort in the day to make whatever efforts you can to resemble the efforts that you make in the night. And you maximize the best 10 nights of the entire year. And the best night of the entire year. A night that is worth 1,000 months. May Allah Azza wa Jal make you and I from those people who stand on Laylatul Qadr, iman and wahtisaba, with iman and expecting the reward. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us from those that He forgives. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us from those who He pardons, because He is afuun ghafoor. He is the one who pardons and the one who forgives. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you and I the tawfiq to get the most out of the 10 days that are coming. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. That's what Allah Azza wa Jalla made easy for me to mention, and Allah knows best. Wassalatu wassalam ala nabina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.